So class 10, yesterday we have started the chapter, The Making of a Scientist. So what this chapter is about? The chapter is about E. Bright, okay? Robert E. Bright, okay? So just to revise the previous lecture, so what kind of child he was? First of all, he was the only child of the parents. He did not have anybody at home to accompany him in his playing. So what he was doing, he usually played alone, okay? He said that, yes, he said that he is not at all interested, and he was not able to accompany the different type of games played in groups or in teams, for example, baseball, soccer and all that. And what he was only playing, he was only collecting the things. So this is the thing in which he has developed his interest in. As a young child, what he was collecting? He was collecting fossils, stones and coins also. And when he was in the grade of 2 to 3, what he has started, he has collected almost all type of butterflies that were available in his hometown. How many different species? How many? 25. 25 different species. Keep it with you. I will click it. Okay. I'll see. Yeah. You just sit. Okay, so what is the role of E. Bright's mother in his development as a good scientist? So his mother has played an active role to bring him up to the level of a scientist, because since his childhood, as he's all alone, his mother is always accompanying him in the dining room. In the evening, they used to spend their evening together, and then afterwards, what they were doing, they were discussing, they were learning various things. His mother used to bring various kind of scientific materials for him. For example, telescopes, microscopes, mounting materials, slides and all that, right? And moreover, she has also, when he has collected all the different kind of butterflies, his mother has brought him the book, Travels of Monarch X. And that has definitely brought a change in his thinking as well as in his learning skills, right? Because earlier he thought that after collecting all the different type of 25 species of butterflies, that would be an end. Okay, that would be an end to his discovery or to his, you can say, interest. But later on, he has found a new direction after that what to do in this field and how to do. So this is what we have read. Mainly, I'm again and again telling you, this person is usually asked, what is the role of his mother? Students usually write down only single line, that her mother used to bring telescopes, microscopes and all that. No. Okay, what are the other roles that I have discussed today? You also have to write down these. Okay, so if it is in 2 to 3 months. So the last paragraph, in order to continue, I'm reading, that probably would have been the end of my butterfly collection, he said. He said that when he has collected all the different types of butterflies, then this would have brought an end to his butterfly collection. But then my mother, she got me a children's book called The Travels of Monarch X. That book, which told how Monarch butterflies migrate to Central America, opened the world of science to the eager young collector. So now what happened? Then when his mother has brought this book to him, this has opened a new world of science in front of him. He has new arena of thoughts in front of him. He has new ideas to think upon and to find out the answers to his questions. So let us read further what he will do. At the end of the book, readers were invited to help study butterfly migration. So in the end of the book, there is a page written, or there is a special mention for the butterfly collectors, that they should help and study how butterflies, they migrate. You know what is migration? Shelter, food, and in the form, yes, climatic conditions. Okay, when the birds, they fly in flocks. So they were asked to tag butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick A. Urquhart of the University of Toronto, Canada. So what was the invitation written at it? That it is written by Professor Urquhart, and what he has written to tag the butterflies for research means whichever butterfly you will see, you have to tag that butterfly. How to tag means you have to mention a special mark on the body of the butterfly, and which was written by Professor Urquhart of University of Toronto, Canada. E. Bright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart, and soon E. Bright was attaching light adhesive tags to the wings of Manas. So see how thin the wings of the butterflies are. Dilpreet, what are you doing? Kindly be quiet. So you know that how thin the wings of the butterflies are, okay? And ultimately what he was doing, he was you can say tagging it with, or by attaching it adhesive tags, something little bit adhesive tape, you can say, that would be used to tag, okay, on the wings of the Monarch. Which category, which species he is talking about? On the Monarch butterflies, okay? So anyone who found a tagged butterfly was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart. So anybody who would find that tagged butterfly, he would send that tag back to Professor Urquhart. This means that this Professor Frederick, he was studying about the migration of the butterfly. See how simple the topic is. But it doesn't mean that if the topic is so simple, the answers will also be expected to be simple. But they have very deep, you can say, it has very deep and close mysteries which can only be brought out only if person studies it to the deep extent. Vineet Roop, stand up. Yes, tell me what Professor Urquhart has written at the end of the book. What he has written in the book Travels of Monarch X. No, you're wrong. Actually, you are not paying attention. Pay attention, sit down. So, finally, the butterfly collecting season around breeding last 6 weeks in late summer. So what is the breeding, that is the collecting season of the butterflies? Only 6 weeks. Okay, 1 month and 2 weeks it is only in summer. So graph is given below. So you can see it from here, number and kinds of butterflies collected in 6 weeks. Snout, he has collected number collected one. Okay, kinds he has mentioned. Monarch also one. Whites and sulfurs, 3. Brush footed, 10. Wood nymphs and stars, 3. And it is gossamer winged. He has collected 8. So if you are going to chase them, chase means follow them, one by one, you won't catch very many. So the next step, pre-bright, was to raise a flock of butterflies. So yes, so what the writer has written, the writer is saying, if you are going to chase them one by one, if you are going to follow one by one, butterfly after one, then another, is it possible to collect the butterflies or to tag them? No. They are so minute creatures. They are very small. They can fly from one place to another, and it is very difficult to get hold of them in order to tag them. Otherwise, so there is no other option to tag them. How you can tag a butterfly? If you will catch the butterfly, it's an insect flying. You won't be able to do. So it is very difficult to chase them, and you won't catch many. So the next step for E. Bright was to raise a flock of butterflies. So the next step, what he has thought was that to raise that butterflies, flock of butterflies, he has to raise in his own house. So see how he has done it. He would catch a female Monarch. Naturally, what for raising the butterflies, what he would need? He would need female Monarch, take her eggs, and raise them in his basement through their life cycle. What is the life cycle of a butterfly? Caterpillar, larva, and then pupa, I think so. Okay, and then the adult, right? So he has let it pass, that is the female butterfly, to let it pass through all the stages of life in order to develop into a complete butterfly. Then he would tag the butterfly's wings and let them go. So before means when they are raised to a complete butterfly, he would tag them and let them fly. So this is how he is doing. So seen here another important thing, that at that very young age, he is so capable of raising the butterflies, because butterflies, they use or they don't breed or they breed under particular conditions. They require particular temperature to develop, and he has maintained all. And then he would tag the butterflies and let them go. For several years, his basement was home to thousands of monarchs in different stages of development. So for many years in his basement, these monarch butterflies, they have been developing into different kind of, passing through different stages of development, and many butterflies they could be seen in his basement. Eventually, as a result means, I began to lose interest in tagging butterflies. Then finally, he has lost his interest in tagging those butterflies. Why he has lost interest in tagging the butterflies? Because it's a very slow process. Okay, as it is very slow process, it is difficult for them to carry on at this slow speed. He wanted some immediate results. He got tired of it. So it's tedious. And there's not much feedback. Yes, of course, that I told that it is not an easy job. It's a tedious work to do. And one cannot get immediate results or instant results. One has to wait for a long time, for much time, in order to get the appropriate feedback that one is expecting. I had tagged, were recaptured, sorry, in all the time I did it, he laughed, only two butterflies I had tagged were recaptured, and they were not more than 75 miles away from my house where I lived. So what he said that it was very slow and tedious process in order to recapture the butterflies which you have tagged. It means you tag the butterfly, you let it fly, it will fly and go anywhere, and when you will find the same butterfly tagged one, you will remove the tag and send it back to Professor Urquhart. Okay, so see, in one season you are tagging and you are expecting them to return in the next season, and out of those butterflies which you have tagged, many, how many can survive? Very short lifespan they have. Okay, a few can be returned back, and this is very difficult, and results are not so possible ones. So it is very difficult for him to maintain a record for all these butterflies. So this is the reason why he lost his interest in tagging the butterflies. So finally, what has happened? So he said that out of all these butterflies that I have tagged, he has raised hundreds of butterflies in his basement. And ultimately, how many have returned? He has recaptured back only two butterflies. And that was also not near his house. It was almost 75 miles away from his house. He has found those butterflies. So it was very difficult for him to carry forward this process. Then, in the seventh grade, he got a hint of what real science is when he entered a country science fair and lost. So, then life hasn't stopped there if he has lost the interest in tagging the butterflies. When he was in class 7, so you people will feel if any assignment is given in science or any other subject, you feel it burdened. Oh, ma'am, what you have done? Ma'am, one after another. So see how you can say how spontaneously he is doing all the work without any, you can say, push up by the teachers. All he is doing is on his own. So when he was in grade 7, means he is experimenting since his childhood. That's great. So when he was in grade 7, he got a hint of what real science is. Then when he has entered, when he has participated in the country science fair. In country science fair means that it is not limited to the schools of that particular area, or it is not limited to the area of a single district, but ultimately schools of all over the country, they are going to participate. So how great or wide spectrum it has. Okay. So that at that moment, he has got a chance to know what actually science is. Science is not only doing these kinds of experiments. It is something else. And it is for the first time that he has come to know what actually science is. Although he participated in that science fair, but unluckily what happened that he has lost the science fair. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not to get anything while everybody else had won something. So he said at that moment, participating in this science fair was really a very sad feeling for me. Why it was a sad feeling for me? It is because he said that everyone who has participated in the fair, everyone who has participated in the fair has got something or the other. But it was really very embarrassing for him to sit in the fair for the whole time, and ultimately you win nothing because he is always in the habit of winning prizes. And at that moment when he did not win any prize, that was really very sad on his part. So Ebright said his entry was slides of frog tissues, which he showed under a microscope. He realized that winners had tried to do real experiments, not simply make a neat display. So what he has done, what thing he has presented in the country science fair, that he has presented a slide of frog tissues. He has just mounted the slide and very neatly he has presented it. But then after participating or after looking at all the students who were winning the prizes, he has come to know that it is not only presenting neat display or neat slides is actually, or it actually makes him to win a prize. For winning, he has to do real experiments that the other children were also doing. So already the competitive spirit that drives Richard Ebright was appearing. I knew that for the next year's fair, I would have to do a real experiment. The subject I knew most about was the insect work I had been doing in the past several years. So this has driven a force in him, driven a competitive force in him, and he was determined that in the next, I will definitely participate in this country fair. But in the next fair, what I should do? I should not present only a display of slides, but what I would represent, I will do the real experiment. Now where, in which field he has to do his experiments? He was thinking. Finally, he has thought that he will do the experiments in the field of only insect work, because he was doing the work on butterflies for several years he has done. So he has thought that he will do the work only on butterflies. And ultimately, he will continue his research work as well as his study work and will present something new in the country science fair. And moreover, he was determined to win a prize in the next country fair. So he wrote to Dr. Kohat for ideas, and back came a stack of suggestions for experiments. So he needed some expert advice. He needed some expertise in order to tell him that what to do and what not to do. So finally, as he was only in touch with Professor Akuhat, for whom he was tagging the butterflies. So he has written, his mother has actually written a letter to Professor Akuhat, and then in suggestion, he has sent him a number of, you can say, suggestions and experiments. From this point, we have also come to know that when you are in a company of a learned person, you learn many things. Okay, so try to keep a healthy company of yours. Those kept Ebright busy all through high school and led to prize projects in country and international science fairs. So whatever experiments he has sent, he was working upon those experiments. He was doing those experiments. And because of these experiments, he was completely busy in his high school. As he was busy in his high school, and for that reason, he was doing his experiments. He was studying various kind of experiments he was doing and getting the results. And finally, because of it, he was able to win many prizes, not in country science fairs, but in international science fairs also. So this is important to be noted here. Okay. And in high school, what were his achievements? That he has won many prizes, not only in country science fair, but in international science fairs also. So let me ask from the topic which we have read. Yes, Raghav, stand up. Raghav Arora. Yes, Raghav, tell me why Ebright did not win a prize in the country science fair? But that didn't earn him any prize. Okay. What he had displayed, Saddam, what he had displayed, Simarpreet? What he had displayed in the country science fair? Saddam, next last boy. what he had displayed, what next Ekjot, sit down, what he very bad, yes, yes, very good, he had this, sit down, he had displayed slide of frog tissues. So why he did not earn prize, what is the reason he had displayed slide of frog tissues, and what reason he had come to know that why he didn't win a prize, yes, it was a simple thing, and what others have done, sit down, yes Raghav, what others have done, they all have done experiments, real experiments, actually they, what they all have done, they all have done real experiments, okay, so sit down, what has developed a competitive spirit in Ebright, Prapreet, what has developed a competitive spirit in Ebright, sit down, next Kirti, what has developed a competitive spirit in Ebright, that he will do real experiments, okay, and for that, sit down, for that Kanishka, what he has done, no, for that, what to do, how he come to know, no, he was determined to do his work on the butterflies only, but actually what he has thought, what to do, actually what he has thought that his mother has written a letter to Professor Akuhat, okay, he has sent him a stack of ideas for experiments, and then he has come to know where to start his work with, and then finally what has been done, he has started his work in the field, Siddhant, please, in the field of insects that he has done, okay, so for his 8th grade project, Ebright tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. In 8th class, which experiment he has done, just underline it, he has experimented about a viral disease which was killing number of monarch caterpillars every few years, means after few years many monarch caterpillars they are being dead. He has found the reason why, it was because of a viral disease. When this happened, when he was in class 8, Kesho, when this happened, when he was in class 8, what happened in class 8? He will tell me, what happened in class 8? What happened in class 8? Sit down, he has worked, yes. If you will focus your energy more on books now, you will give better answers. I don't ask, I don't expect these silly answers. Please keep it to yourself. Yes, he is able to find the cause of the viral disease which was killing monarch caterpillars after every few years. So Ebright thought the disease might be carried by a beetle. He tried raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles. I didn't get any results, but I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment and this time I won. So it means that it's not only the results that matters, if you are doing the things that also matters. He said that everyone was thinking that it is because of beetles this disease was being spread, and it is because of beetles that these monarch caterpillars were being dead, okay, but finally what he did, he raised the caterpillars among the beetles, but he said, I was not able to find the actual result or actual reason why this was happening, but finally what has happened, but I won that. It means that if you are trying something, that also makes you acknowledged, okay, that's all for today, and tomorrow we will continue further with that, okay, if you have any questions, you can ask me.